What's up, people? Here with my F3 jersey on because some stuff just went down. For sure, there was some things all on the line for everything's with Dark 55. Man, yeah, he had his Goro ready, and he was saying that he's gonna beat me, and he needs to be on F3 and all this stuff. He's so good. I said, okay, all right. We played, and I was like, my sponsorship's on the line, dude. You're getting it. You're on the team. You're replacing me if you win. Do you think? Who do you guys think won? Leave it in the comment below. Liu Kang. All right. Purple, green, red. I think. Okay, and he went Dragon's Fire. That's much better. Flame Fist against Reptile is not exactly the best. There's pretty good options for him out of the windmill. So that's what you gotta ask yourself. After windmill punches, what are my options? And Reptile has good ones. But this is Dragon's Fire though. So on this one, he's got great pressure and great zoning. So, but I'm comfortable zoning a Liu Kang. They'll typically try to fly kick in like that, so you just gotta be ready for it. Oh, the overhead. He's not gonna break. Good. He's competent. He's a competent player. For sure. Oh, jumped right in. Let's go for the this time back three. Wow. Wow, 100, 119 MS. That was just supposed to be knee slide. Nothing came out though. Missed that convert for sure. Ooh, I slid a little early there. That's I needed to slide and make the force ball connect. So that low slide would have popped him up, and he could have caught that force ball. I slid in too early because I thought he was gonna try something. I guess I don't know. Bad read. Yeah. So you can. I was kind of just running around, but not full screen running around. It was just like I was trying to stay right out of his forward four range because that's what he wants to come up to you and start his low forward four and then get into his pressure that's gonna do like a bunch of chip, so or even open you up if you don't know what you're doing. So yeah, Liu Kang. I wouldn't say Liu Kang is necessarily a hard matchup for Reptile. It's probably even. People used to say that Liu Kang was really hard for Reptile, but I played it a lot, and I've never lost to a Liu Kang in tournament. And I've played some pretty decent Liu Kangs. The best one I played, I suck because I can't remember his name, but he beat Zyfox in the mirror in a tournament one time, and I played him and. It was bodied. It was kind of bad, but it wasn't necessarily because I was that much better. It was just because he didn't really know the Reptile matchup. But here we go. Is this guy 79? Probably plays Reptile. Decided to go Sub-Zero, maybe thinking to counter pick, but went with the wrong variation here. Yep. I got a good idea. Let's jump. Yep, I knew it. If I could only anti-air a little better. Alright, the slide. Oh. You want to come back to the corner, bro. Oh. Okay. I thought he was going to jump or something. That's why I did that. NJKs. They have big hitboxes. Ooh, didn't wanna. Damn it, I messed that up. Whatever. I wasn't thinking. I forgot how to convert because he got hit by that little, not the low, so I was like. Whatever.
Reptile wins. Flawless victory.
bit slow on the online here, taking a little longer than usual, it seems like. My console's not exactly in the best shape. It's been freezing a lot lately and doing a lot of stupid stuff. I think I'm gonna get rid of my Xbox because it's really just a waste of space. I'm glad that Xbox 360s can play Blu-rays. I mean, Xbox Ones can play Blu-rays, but that's really the only good use for it to me. So I'll just like put it. I'm gonna put it like in my bedroom and watch stuff on it. That's it. I don't think I want to buy any more games on it, and there's not really a reason to play Mortal Kombat X on Xbox if you have a PS4. There's more people, I feel like, on PS4, so that's why I decided to just stop, and I'm just going to play ranked in PS4 and see how high I can get up in the ranks before I want to kill myself from playing this game. Terror Global. Okay, Jax player. 56. So I guess that's a kind of a decent level. Yep. Sometimes when I whiff that 4-2-1, I'll just do meter burn claw because I know they're going to try to whiff punish it with something that isn't going to be frame tight. Ooh. Yeah, this is a super laggy connection. We're up to the two hundos. Zone. Yep. Thought he might try to make a trade. I would have, because I would have tried to build meter. What do you want? Oh. Still get hit by the string, the overhead part. 4-4-1, the second hit's an overhead. So a lot of players will get hit by that. This guy's gonna get zoned out if he doesn't. Like, yeah, he's done. Forward four slide and 4-4-1 is what you need to know if you want to start playing Reptile. Forward four slide, that's your risky thing that you do for conditioning. You got to do it a couple times. You need to do it enough to where they get annoyed with forward four slide. And then as soon as they think that you're going to be risky and do it again, it normally takes about three. So on average, it's about 3 4-4 slides to condition an opponent. And then all of a sudden, your 4-4-1 will be opening people up. And that's why Nimble is the best, is because it gets those highest conversions off of 4-4-1. And when Reptile goes for mix-ups, if he's going to try to break 30 mid-screen, he's going to have to use a bar. Typically, and I mean, there's very small, not practical. Well, no, actually, off mix-ups, you always do have to spin meter to get some good damage. That's why 4-4-1 is just the most prominent string for a Reptile player. Oh, I got over him. Nice. Oh, wow, we're doing terrible. Come on. Lero, we're making this look ugly. And of course, Cryo. Cryo sub instead of Grandmaster sub. Let's see, a slide. Yeah. Wow. Predictable. Round two. Fight. What's wrong? Let's see, got him started with something that he likes. Another, oh, this time with the down two, caught me. See how I can just like jump around this guy? Oh. Damn it. I wanted my convert. I'll get it. Of course you're pressing stuff. There's the slide into the force ball. You can actually, one of the best setups for it is that sort of mid to mid close range. If you kind of just like get to it and then throw a meter burn slow force ball, then you can slide and take that risk with feeling comfortable, because there is a force ball, so it's not going to be as negative whenever they block the slide and then they have to block the force ball right afterwards. But I'm pretty sure it's still going to be their turn after they block that. Feels safer, of course. And if the slide hits, then you get the damage from, you know, a force ball pop up. Faction battle. Okay, so Melina, definitely one of Reptile's toughest matchups, but I would say that it's doable as long as you get in and you do your best to be offensive, and basically that's the only way, because you can't zone her at all, really. Some of them you might be able to, but that little flip I just did, you're going to see that a lot from me in this matchup. Okay. Oh. Yeah, keep him over here. Of course, the roll wake up. This is the... Oh, man. Oh, good block. Okay. I wonder if he hits me with something, at least I can... yeah, whatever. You know, finish it with slide, build a little bit of meter. The flip, you know, just to let him know, don't zone me. Don't try it too much. Okay, got some zoning. He's gonna do it a little bit. I'm gonna try to teach him. Oh my gosh. What is this? And then I probably also don't get the win for this. Yeah, that's probably how this works. Thank you, no longer available. Good attitude. Okay. Stupid. Back on the subject though of Melina, it's not necessarily a winning matchup for you. It's probably like a 6-4 as a Reptile player, and you're gonna want Nimble, I think. That's, yeah, I don't see a reason why you would want to use the other one, so. And most likely you're going to be going against Piercing. Now, if you weren't going against Piercing, maybe you could use some of the other variations, and it would feel okay. It's really just preference. And I don't know why people are saying that Deceptive is, as some people apparently are saying, that Deceptive is Reptile's best variation. It's not Nimble, but they're freaking high, because that's not right. If anybody actually like sat down and tried to figure out the gaps and stuff, like for Deceptive or how to deal with it, like they did with Liu Kang when he was such a problem, and like they have done with certain other characters, then you would realize it's a bunch of talk, and it's not as good as they say. A lot of holes are in Deceptive pressure. It's full of holes now, and it didn't used to be. So back when I made my guide, it was the best. You could do a lot with it, but a lot of options out of the meter burn invisibility. But now your option out of meter burn invisibility is a risk every time. A pretty huge risk. Whereas before there was that one extra hit that you got to put in there, because you could do meter burn invisibility into a down three and it would all be jailed. Alien, I hate
Do alien. You mock me, alien?
Round one, fight.
Ooh, yep. See, a lot of times people don't punish that, or they don't go with the proper move whenever they're taking their turn, because they don't realize it's punishable. So I'll do meter burn claw, and I'll get people with it all the time. Okay, same blocking. Damn. I gotta get this guy back in the corner. I hate standing here with my back towards the corner like this. Just figured hard knockdown, chip him out. No reason to do anything else. Yeah, he's not gonna outzone me. I'm not scared of that. Ooh. Alright, armor. Coming. Okay, what you want? The low? Yep. Not gonna break it? You're not realizing how much this hurts, bro. Okay. Yo, huge shout outs to Sennheiser for hooking it up with some new headphones. That was awesome. Best headphones on the market for sure. All right, so far we've had pretty good matches with different character variety. It's nice to see Alien, Melina. We still got a couple more Scorpions we need to see, so don't worry, they're probably coming up. They'll be here shortly. Approach? Let's see who this guy plays. Alright. So with Raiden, typically what I go into each match thinking is he's going to do the Superman thing. He's going to try to do it at some point. So you got to be respectful in your zoning. It's like my friend Justin says, it's a little bit more... He calls my zoning adaptive zoning. And what he likes to do is more so just like evil zoning. Just like Pig, you know. Pig is kind of both. Pig is the ultimate zoner. Dude, shout outs to Pig. Wow, there's a Superman. Damn. He's gonna stay. Oh, I messed up that jet jump. I tried to step forward, but with this 200, I mean, I tried to step back before, but with this 200 MS, it's like I didn't get it. Such a light little feather step is not gonna come out sometimes. What is this guy? Okay. He's just gonna let me. I thought he was gonna break that, so that's why I just kept going. Freestyled it a little bit. You can get like 53 out of that. With a good combo. You can do forward, four, spit, forward, four, spit, forward, four, slide. Then you can do forward, four, one, two, force ball, uppercut, forward, four, one, two, slide. And that's 53. But sometimes whenever you do try to press, what's gonna happen is, you may see me press 441 sometimes in the corner for these corner converts, but I'm trying to press 44 into the acid spit. It just happens to be down 41 for the acid spit. So sometimes, especially with online, I get just the one by itself and it didn't read the directions into it. But it really doesn't score you that much less damage when you do that. It's still easy to convert. It may take you about, if you are going to start playing Nimble Reptile, it may take you about 2 weeks to really have a convert from every single type of stray hit that you may be seeing. And that includes things like on the setups, whenever you go into meterless Nimble and you jump over, you're trying like a jump four or something, and then you're going to go, maybe you try to go for something like a back three or a back two, or maybe just start 4-4-1-2. Well, you need to know how to convert off of that, is what I'm saying. So when you need to recognize, like, oh, they're hit, and let me convert, and what's something substantial for a combo and online, too. Okay. Oh. Hit. Punish. Oh, wow. I did not get the punish. This, oh. Yeah, this thing is lying. It just went from 50 ping to 90. And then back. So. Wow. Yeah, that's what we're dealing with here. What, once again, like, not reading the direction and just getting a standing four like that instead of forward four, that's the type of stuff that can happen on kind of wavy connections. Oh, it's cool to hear the water.
Round two, fight.
Oh. Okay, he's got me. What's he got? Setup? Slasher may not really have setups. I don't know. It seems like it's pretty good, and I think everything's good though. What you want? Oh, the overhead. Sorry fans. Sorry sports fans, letting you down here, missing these converts.
Reptile wins.
That's right. Give me another one. That connection, that was a lie. That was not 50 MS the whole time. That kind of jumped. It does that, though. It'll tell you that somebody's connection, even if it's like a friend of yours that you'll play that's close by, and we have the same internet. At one point, you know, I figured, okay, let's play it. It'll be fine, and it'll tell you, oh, this is a 200 ping or whatever, and it like lies. It was like perfect when I sat down to play it, so... I don't know what's up with that.
Takeda.
Oh, okay. William Chilliam. I like that. And he picked... Takeda's not a character you see often. I wouldn't say he's the rarest. Reptile is rare. Reptiles are pretty... I don't run into very many other reptiles. Good start. Okay. That's cool. Nice, this is gonna be a good match. Let's see. Oh. I'm caught with the overhead. 441. The low, okay. Just to let him know I'm mixing it up. The low. Oh, what? See, what? No 441, it was just 44 by itself. Whatever. Ronin. Yeah, Ronin. It's good. Oops. I'm hammered here. Okay. Got him in the corner. This next round is gonna start off pretty well for me. I have more meter too, so. Of course. People are trying to press stuff a lot after... Wow, I can't believe that didn't connect. People try to press stuff off the jump four a lot, though.
Finish him.
How about you spam the same combo some more, you fucking bitch-ass faggot? Yeah, you fucking gay-ass nigga, bro. Overhead. That's the only thing you fucking...
The overhead?
Garbage, bro. And give your friend the control, because you're not a fucking 38. You don't.
Yeah. Sure, bro. Ronin is good. I like Ronin. I think if I played Takeda, I probably would play Ronin Takeda. Because it... I like that stutter pressure that I see done with the swords. And the swords, of course, they make such a cool sound. So, I would play Ronin. I know, actually already know a little bit of Lasher just because of Mr. Professor Dr. Pepper. Maybe he just goes by EGP Professor now. I know he was with EGP. I think he still is. He's a great Lasher. And also, my buddy Justin, he just goes by JJNN44NB, I think that's like his tag. But he's a really good lasher too. He knows like the ins and outs of lasher, so. And he hasn't been playing fighting games for a long time, so it's like he's picking, this is like his first one, and he's picking it up pretty quick. Okay, Tanya, and she didn't go, this is Pyro, so you don't see this often. This is pretty rare too. Wow, that sucks for her. Okay. Yep, the convert, okay. A lot of times in the corner, on these meaty back threes, it's good to just throw the back three by itself and don't throw a back 3-4, because you can do back three and see that it doesn't hit and typically stand up and get some more pressure. And if it does hit, it has a decent hit advantage. It's okay. So you go for something again. Yep. Kind of break. Okay. This is gonna be dead. I don't know. Like, see, the thing about matches that are only one match like this is I can't really gauge how good of a player that guy was, because he could be really good. A lot of stuff like this, like learning where to stand in a new matchup, or learning when you can move or when you can jump, things like that, like even off pressure, like when it's okay to even try to jump out or whatever it may be, all these things can be baited and expected. And when you don't know a matchup, sometimes it may look really bad the first time you play it, or a few times, of course it does, it looks bad, but then once you learn it, which could only take like 3 or 4 matches before you start making these major adjustments, they could totally change. Like that guy, maybe that guy can beat me, he's higher level than me, and he just needs more time with the matchup. And Ferator is a character that is really good in the Reptile matchup, I feel like. It's understandable, like, the certain spots where Ferator needs to be, and it's understandable, like, how it should work, but it doesn't ever seem to play out the way that it would on paper. Oh. Damn. Yeah, I'm not trying to spin my meter just yet. Wow. Yeah, lag. On these, oh my god, I'm going to stop doing NJPs. I'm just going to do like 2-1 or something, because that's ridiculous. As big of a character as he is, for me to jump up and be missing those or mistiming them, it's not worth it. No more NJPs. He didn't want any of that anyway. But what I mean by the Ferator matchup is, Ferator, I guess, you know, you would classify him as a grappler, brawler type grappler, and you want to try to stay away from him, of course, with Reptile. You want to try to stay out. You want to try to see if you can zone him, but because his jump's not great, and he can't like get through force balls as easy as you would think. But he can, and Lackey, he can just, you know, it's like everything's safe. He can meter burn through a lot of stuff to come in on you. So a Ferator that, like a Biohazard has, Biohazard beat me at NEC. I played him, and he had, it was somewhat close, I think. I can't really remember what happened. I wasn't playing Nimble at the time, of course. I was still playing Noxious, which I think is the worst variation that he has, maybe. It's, who knows, who cares when you got Nimble. It's like Nimble. I'll try to just, you know, keep playing Nimble and showing people, look, these setups, look how often people let you do them. Like something, I know I messed up, but I was trying to cost. I'll do 2-1, forward 4-1, activate Basilisk and jump. See, look how many people let you do that. If he would have tech roll, wake up, charge grab thing, he probably would have punished that setup. Maybe, I don't know, but it doesn't matter. What the problem is, is after 441, no one's tech rolling often, so I get that jump four like that. This has just been a cluster cheese match. There you go. Okay. I could have blocked that one though, I'm pretty sure. I just was running in to start pressure and try it. Oh shit. Not, yeah, when I'm in his face like this, that sucks. I'm about to have three bars though, this is done. Throw some stuff at him. Ooh. Yeah. Definitely. Alright. Helps to get some space. He was holding down, trying to delay. I think that's the max. So, like, he was holding down, and that was the max amount of time that he could hold down, so he had to stand up and eat some of the chip. But he just wasn't even... He was, like, still just holding down, I guess, and not block. I don't know. Who knows? Whatever it was. Not smart. I would have... Let's see. What would I have done in that situation? I would have probably... tech roll jump and seeing what the reptile player was going to do. I would try tech roll jump. I know that seems risky as hell because if they went in for something, but he just like delayed and then got hit by that back three four. I don't even know if you could jump out of that. I don't know. There would be stuff I would try, obviously. I would come through with something. Typically wake ups are the best option, so he would have been good with just like the wake up grab thing. That would have hit me. Didn't have enough health to support it though. He pretty much lost it a lot before then. He was done. So we got our scorpions finally. Hope you guys are liking that. Always super important. Hold up, I gotta check something. Dang. Old video.
For Satera.
For Shirai Ryu.
For the final time.
Fight. All that exchange and... He's a typical scorpion, right? low internet speed, high amounts of teleporting. Can't even confirm. I hate the bad connection. That was stupid. I'm frustrated right now. I'm doing stupid stuff. Okay. Ooh! Teleport. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I ran in for the meaty jump four just to see, and okay. I mean it. Turned out good. God. Okay. He knows to wait on the claw at least. Didn't get the down three. Down three. That's what I wanted. Oh, good block. This guy's feeling the pressure. Oh, good uppercut, I guess. I don't know. I called me on something. I think Scorpion is not the best for Reptile, for fighting Reptile. Even though I've lost to Scorpions before, you can get hit. And of course, you can get into a situation where it's going to be hard to get out of. But as far as like the neutral goes, and playing Scorpion in general, it doesn't feel hard ever. I know you can't throw force balls as much. You can't like jump as much, but... You just Most scorpions, you just walk down and you let them hang themselves, it seems like. That's honestly like how I approach most scorpions online. They're gonna be waited out by one of the most aggressive characters in the game. Challenge if that makes accepted. Any sense. Like, Reptile is one of the most aggressive, and I'm sitting there like holding block, waiting out teleports because they're so dumb. Alright, Liu Kang again. I wonder if I played this guy earlier, and maybe now he's going Flame Fist instead of Dragon's Fire, which is not smart, but I don't know, he's level 70. He's way higher than me. Who knows what I'm... I don't know what I'm talking about. He could beat my ass. We'll see.
I'm looking for Earthrealm blood.
And so you have found it.
Round one, fight.
Yep, started off with a 4-4-1. Ooh. Yeah, this connection's horrible. Check. Make the trades. Keep him over in the corner. Oh. Oh. That's, of course, an area right there when you want to try to punish when Liu Kang does that kick over your head like that, and then he's left like in a whiff, pretty much. Ooh. What the hell is happening here? Good lord. Oh. This is great. I think I'm just gonna let myself die. Okay.
Use your head or lose it.
Use my head. Alright, use my meter. How about that? Oh. Oh, man. That Ford 4 spit was not intended, if you're wondering. Yeah, no way that's happening, I guess, on this connection. MS 200. Yes. Great time to possibly showcase some of the zoning, but whenever you're that far away, it's like... Lost connection. Cord's not plugged in all the way. Something stupid. Yeah. Reptile. Oh, reptile player. Let's see. Oh, man. What happened? Maybe I'll get him again. Here we go. Rambling Boozer. How about you play someone like Gora? Hey, this guy probably plays a unique character. Raiden? Somewhat. I think this is definitely one of the coolest looking costumes for Raiden. Okay. Yep, just wait. Damn it. There it is. Oh! Yeah, sorry, this is another lag station. Lag central station.
You smell of desperation.
Got the meter? Yeah. Ooh, that was nice. I wonder if he knew I was gonna flip. Okay, yep, could have gotten Superman on me. There. see what he does. Oh, no, Superman, wake up. Damn it. Yeah, he's gonna... Could have sworn that was gonna be it. Ooh. I don't really know the Raiden matchup very much. I never played it like a lot. So all I know is I treat it kind of similar to Scorpion. Like I just wait for the Superman, or if he's playing Displacer, you may see me throw out random like 1-2s, because I'll do like 1-2, and when I realize like that it's punishing a teleport or something, then I just type the force ball in and get the convert. So I have had some cool moments where I was like standing there and I just felt like a teleport was coming, and I press 1-2 and Reptile will actually turn around and hit the person. So that's good.
Man, this shit's gonna be fucking laggy.
Yeah, and this... Okay, let's see who this guy plays. Pikita. Ronin. Alright.
Yeah, you better end
it. Yeah. This is a matchup that's a little difficult for Reptile. This guy's good, though. 74. Everyone I'm playing is, like, pretty much higher rank than... I don't even know if I've ever got any of my accounts up to 70. Wow, dude, you're playing on wireless. Yeah. This sucks. Okay, he's got full meter now, so let's see what he does. Throw the sword down, of course. We're both probably sitting there mashing our buttons. And, yeah. Yeah, that was so super laggy. That sucks when it's like that. This is depressing. I'm probably gonna stop playing soon. This is... I don't know why I even sat down to do that. Why did I even get hype? It's like, why did I even get so hype about sitting down and playing this right now? This sucks. I could be swimming right now. I'm here playing Sniper Paw. Let's see what he has to say about the Reptile matchup. You're one of the last people I'm playing, bro. And he goes Grandmaster. Good answer. Good answer for sure. I think as long as he doesn't slide too much, then we'll be all right. We won't have to pull our hair out. Round one. Put a clone up, please. There you go. Where is it? Damn it, bad trade on my part. Horrible trade. Damn. Kind of bullshit. Oh, one thing I will say about the Grandmaster. One thing I will say about the Grandmaster matchup is, at least You like that? I'll take my hand off like that. At least with Grandmaster, down one has a use. With Reptile, down one's not that great. It's only for like extending combos in the corner if you don't want to use down three, I guess. Why would you want to use down one? But down one is good for the Sub-Zero matchup because it tends to reach a little bit further when that clone's out, so you can kind of poke through the clone with down one only at certain distances. Yep, he's wasting all his meter. When they're doing that, you know it's like desperate. Oh, here we go. Let's see what you got. It was too late. Ooh, I got lucky on that. That could have froze me. That when I tried to down four there. Oh. This guy's not bad. Ooh, good overhead. Nice. But I got the meter now, so should be able to close it out. Final round. I didn't even have a bar. I think, okay. He's gonna try his best to hang on to that bar this time. Ooh, I'm being too aggressive. Damn it. There we go. Let's see if we can get, ooh! Yeah, no one ever punishes that correctly. That's why I throw that claw out like that. Okay, dude. Enough of this. Enough of the corner stuff. I gotta get out of here. I don't know. Let's see. I didn't even want to. That backdash was unintentional for sure. Okay, dude. Enough of this. Yeah, it's not your turn. Wow, no 2-1. Just. There we go. It was like the hardest thing just to get to the other side. Like, as soon as I could get over there, though, I instantly just felt like super confident. I was like, oh, okay. Not in the corner anymore. Like, just simple, smooth sailing here. So that's good. We got our Grandmaster sub. Always gonna have one of those. Every session. Sit down, play Grandmaster sub. Get a drink. Play a Scorpion. Faction battle. Oh, I wish Rain was in the game so bad. Rain is tight. Rain is super tight. No idea who this guy is going to play as. He probably plays someone like Shanks or, I don't know. Zoner. Mm-hmm.
Prove your worth. You will remember my sting. I've already forgotten your name.
Damn. Fight. Okay. Okay, Necro. I used to train for this. Alucard plays Necro. This is nothing. Oh, yeah. How about you get comfortable? Ooh, you're gonna jump. So you gotta forward jump, or you're not gonna deal with that well. Maybe he wanted forward jump and just got neutral, but whatever. Ooh, punish. Nope. Mm. Oh, you don't want to try to zone me anymore? Of course not. Yep. Hey, how do you like getting punished for that? So that's, yeah, he had a better idea the first match he was playing. He was trying to zone a little bit more. Once you realize Reptile gets past that zoning rather easily, I think you just don't want to play Shinnok, Necromancer anymore against him.